Ciao a tutti! Welcome back to my channel. Bentornati sul mio canale. Oppure benvenuti. If we haven't met before, hi, my name is Katie. Vivo in Italia. Vivo qua in Puglia. This video is all about mozzarella. One of the best cheeses there is. And more specifically, about the difference between bufala mozzarella and fior di latte. So the obvious basic breakdown is that bufala mozzarella comes from buffaloes, whereas fior di latte is cow's milk. When I was growing up in the Midwest in America, Italians, close your ears, I thought that mozzarella was like the shredded stuff you get in a bag. I didn't think of this amazing, beautiful, fresh balls of mozzarella that has become my new norm since I've lived in Italy. Moving here has been a game changer for me in terms of what good mozzarella is. But there is a question that remains in terms of what is the difference really between bufala mozzarella and cow's milk mozzarella? How does it taste different? Now, I learned from my years working as a cheesemonger in London at Neil's Yard Dairy, which I write about in my book, Cheese, Wine, and Bread, Discovering the Magic of Fermentation in England, Italy, and France. I learned as a cheesemonger that the best way to get to know cheese is simply to taste it, and a lot of it, often. So that's what I'm gonna do with you today, with these two famous Italian cheeses. Okay, and a third. I'm gonna throw in some burrata as well, because burrata is from right around where I am living. It's from the next town over, and it's stinking delicious, and it has some similarities to mozzarella, so basically I just use any excuse to buy some and to eat it. Speaking of buying the cheese, I have to quickly thank my Patreon community, the Quirky Club. You guys are amazing. This is the group of people who help me make these videos. They support me. It's the reason that I'm able to go to the cheese shop and splurge on these incredible cheeses. Thank you so much, Quirky Club. And in exchange for supporting me, they get monthly recipes, live chats on pizza night, behind the scenes footage. Check that out if you like the content that I'm making. Here we've got the bufala. Here we've got the fior di latte. This is the fior di latte. This is cow's milk. It's so good. This I got from my local caseificio, my local cheese shop. They make it every single morning in the back. It's the best mozzarella that I've ever had. So, I thought I would start with tasting this one because I'm familiar with it. I eat it all the time and it's great and I love it. I mean, there's a nice saltiness, honestly. It's saltier than the mozzarella, the fresh mozzarella balls I remember finding in America. It's just lovely. Okay, nothing to not love about that. Let's do the bufala. Oh my gosh. It's almost like a different cheese. It's so good. Like the taste is markedly different, the flavor. It's a little richer. And yeah, just almost like more savory or more, it like fills your mouth more. I didn't finish the fior di latte. Oh yeah, it's so interesting going back to the fior di latte after the bufala. It's like, it's almost like there's something like missing. It's like an ingredient wasn't added or something. It just kind of doesn't have that extra like oomph, you know? So bufala mozzarella is from Campania, a region in Italy, in southern Italy, that is just to the west of where I am here in Puglia. And it has a DOP, in English it's PDO, Protected Designation of Origin. This is also something I write all about in my book. This protects certain foods, such as cheeses, also wines, all kinds of things. And another thing that I talk a lot about in the cheese section of the book is milk. The milk, because it's the starting point, it's essential to the kind of cheese it will become. And I think that comparing these two kinds of cheese is the perfect example of this. because made in the same method, and yet they seem like completely different products almost. And that has to do with the fact that buffalo milk is higher in fat content, higher in protein content, versus cow's milk, which has higher water content. I mean, you can really taste that. Okay, so those are my quick and dirty thoughts on bufala mozzarella versus fior di latte. Let's hear from an Italian, from my new friend, Roberto.
Oh, ciao, ciao, amici.
Preferisci bufala mozzarella oppure fior di latte?
It's a difficult question. I prefer bufala. Anche se sono pugliese, e qui non è terra della bufala, la bufala è più terra campana, però preferisco la bufala, c'ha quel sapore in più che la rende unica.
Sì.
È più buona.
So I'm including burrata in this taste test as a tangent.
La burrata sì. È unica.
Sì.
Burrata è
incredibile.
È incredibile, è una sì. cosa che solo qui fanno sì. e quando viene riprodotta in altre parti non è la stessa.
Let's eat. So basically with burrata, the outside portion is this elastic cheese, very, very similar. It's basically mozzarella. The inside is stracciatella, which is again, you know, relatively similar. Cow's milk cheese, a fresh cheese. It's so good.
Come preferisci mangiare bufala mozzarella? Oppure fior di latte, tutte e due?
La bufala sicuramente sulla pizza, basta. E però anche un bel piatto con delle con la mozzarella tagliata a fette, pomodori, filo d'olio, sale e anche origano in questo caso, va bene così.
That's my mozzarella roundup. Let me know what you think in the comments. Do you have a preference between buffalo mozzarella, cow's milk mozzarella? Do you have a favorite way of eating mozzarella? Let me know, I wanna try it all. Thanks as always for watching. Thanks to the Quirky Club. I will see you all back here next week. Ci vediamo, alla prossima, ciao.